Welcome to this new streaming about Whistle Mixer 1919 2.1 beta. Alright, today I'm going to work with a sample which is called Jungle Rim Floor. Open it. And this is the sample. Today I will make some modification as the first screenshot that you can see. First of all, this sample start from here, from a plane 2 meters for 2 meters. It's part of the flat base. And this is Whistle Mixer. And in Whistle Mixer, you can show more tiling, for example. And after that, was the flat base. In the flat base, you can change the diffuse color. Like this, when you apply the apply command. All right. However, I am keeping the same color. And after that, there are another layer which looks like this one. Basically, for example, soil or concrete or simple tiles in general. After that, there is a mask like this one, where are basically fine erosion, definition, large irregularities, tiles. If I hide everything, of course, there is only a concrete layer or something like that. Very flat. After that, there are some tiles which are represented like this. Next, large irregularities, where can access all of this one, for example, change this one, worldly two, to simples, to purling, to worldly one, or to worldly three. The original one was worldly two. Of course, there are some settings, for example, seed, amplitude, frequency of taps, lacunary, persistence, etc. Inverse command, for example, this one. Kit original. And all of these represent this set, which is called large irregularities. After that, there are other group which is called definition. We define basically the flat surface, of course, with some bevel details here and there and there. Definition helps, of course, brightness, contrast. After that, there are some sub-erosion, which is has basically Gaussian or directional. Gaussian looks good, and there is strains I can keep the original in memory and change. For example, these cases, and try to get a very good adjustment. All right, a reverb for the original one, enter. That's it. All right. And after that, there are some final options. Check. And, well, in fact, it was in final option. Some of them are this one, are part of the final option, etc. All right. After that, let's see, I already chose the final option. I modify like this the strength. This is some modifications, maybe like this, etc. Try to change to the directional. Change the angle, for example, or kit original, kit Gaussian, and revert this value to the original one, like this. Of course, Quizzle Mixer have tiling. For example, if I activate this preview tiling, of course, when a part of the material finish, start in the other parts. Of course, I can show the grid too and see how does it looks with tiling or without tiling, and where is the grid basically. Let's hide the grid. All right. Of course, there are some other kind of blending modes. Original is multiply, could be normal, is different, could be add, subtract, multiply, is the original one, divide, different. Mass, minimal, step, overlay, and distort. All right, let's keep the original one, multiply, and of course change the opacity, etc. Well, let's change to the other layer, which is called details. Alright, the details, there are other settings I can hide, and of course there are some edge details, this one is. There are threshold, radius, preserve details, remove edge details, of course I can change the diffuse color, for example, more or darker, I mean, or other one, other color, maybe this one and some orange or darker. I think the original one is the best for this example. Alright, of course, if I can change to from below, pues it could be appear like that, opacity mask, or keep the original from above. Of course, there is the mask too, which is basically multiply mode. There are some other textures. For example, this one. Let's show their details, their properties, sample range 1, frequency balance 1, levels 0.5, 0.5, 4.5, use underlying normals, or use lower normals. Of course, it's underlying normals. That's why it is appearing like that. I can hide, and the details for the edge disappear. In the cut details, where there are another property, for example, range, repeat, curve, mirror, etc. Inside field, I can show the properties, use lower normals, the change, or use the original one, use order line normals, it appear more, a very small details, etc., etc. Or invert. The other one is blur. Course erosion too, can high erosion, blur is Gaussian or could be directional. In this example, is like Gaussian. Strain is let's see others order values. It's close to zero. I preserve the original one. All right. And after that, there are another layer which is called root ground. It of course is root ground where all these add all of these details. I can go to the root ground, and this is basically from below or could be from above. The original one is the best settings, and there are others properties, threshold, radius, preserve details, opacity, grab to base, remove base details, high frequency, low frequency, threshold. I can move the threshold. It appears to the smallest values. The humus could be more greater than the original one. In this case was 60. Threshold 6. Of course, I could change the diffuse. For example, maybe there were yellow ground or yellow earth. Or another color, maybe like that, or maybe blue, or real one is, for example, close to gray earth. However, this is called root ground. It's basically ground. All right, I could change other color. For example, close to the orange ones or yellows, orange ones like this one or saturated. Maybe like this one, there were plenty of humus or other kind on earth or ground. Maybe soil, maybe other kind of material in the floor. Basically, all of these ones, all of these range of colors. real colors, maybe like this one, close to black greens. All right, I think the original one is the best one for this example. Repetition, two, and the things change. One, this could be the best one. By the way, let's save this material, say as mastering mixer, and I would like to name this material tree. Let's say, all right. Etc. There are some other properties. The last layer is called moss. I can show the mask, and it's basically composed of all of these three layers. Well, I can show the first one is the top ground. I can show the its properties. For example, let's change the angle, something like that. Use underlie displacement or use layer displacement. Let's change everything. The default one is the best one. And let's revert to the original value. It's the first one. The other one is the root mask. The root mouse is trying to discover some details from the depth tree of this part, or some depth tree, or simply humus. All right. For root mask, there are all these details. Invert for default. Or no. For default is the best one. Use layer normals. The default use on the right normals is the best one. In this example, sample jar 3, 4, could be like that. 5, 6, 6, maximum 5. 3 is the best. All right, how about the bottom ground? I can change the details. Could change this angle. One more time, use layer displacement. It looks good, the general. Or use the original one, use underlie displacement. All right, the original one looks good. In this case, it's at the blend mode. Could be the other one is. That's all. This is basically all of the settings that have this example or the sample. Now I will try to make a basic modification. Of course, as you see what you saw at the beginning of this streaming, there were images where this square were changed for All the round down ones, round ones. How can will we change these squares for round ones? It's very simple. Only try to work in the first layer, which is called black base. I go to that. After that, there are the tiles, lawyers, and there is the this mask, and there is a very special texture there is the flat base, tiles, edge tiles, the mask, root ground, moss, plane, flat base. And for example, in tiles, the precreator, for example, this is an old version of patterns. Ha. Let's see, I haven't seen. I applied that command where it was showing, and already there is an extra option that I was looking for. This option, I am working in tiles in this mask, and after apply that command that you saw 1 minute ago, there is other options. It's square and in circles. The purpose of these modifications are to show the circle one, this one, circle. And as you can see, immediately the change take place and the pattern change from a square to the round one or ones. And this is very interesting pattern because this is the one that I was looking for. All right. Of course, I can change repetition in X and Y, for example, C's to C's. And there are other smaller patterns, for maybe there were a floor with some other smaller ones. All right. Let's change this one to A to A. 8 only. and are smaller ones, of course. Let's keep the original for the moment. Of course, I can change to other one. For example, check checkers, and also I can go to the texture. And of course, I am in the texture too. Already, I am in the texture. I can change this one. For example, horizontal. And the field chains of vertical was the original one. Or chain for the other one is gradient. And the most is almost in this right side. And the left side is basically root, etc. And some details of some roots or free roots or some depth trees. All right, let's back and see what happened. This one. The fins. I was working here in the tiles. However, all right. Let me see what happened. I was working here, and I was working in tiles. However, I wonder why the fins change. All right. Well, for the moment is I am using gradient tiles. Worldly, no tiles. Gradient, no. Ah, yes, that's what. That was because I am in the last option, which is called gradient. Of course, if I choose gradient, for the property change to the gradient. Check, let's change to checker and fan to the horizontal or the vertical. All right. It's very interesting, all of these properties. Gradient, for example, gradient can change this angle and try to increase the half or zero degrees. Well, the most is in the right side. If I change to 90, with precision 90, well, pues, with the flag details are the offside, etc. For example, if I change into the other angle, for example, 180. That's the change. If I change to 217, this one with precision is 90 degrees, for example, this one, and the most is the material is plenty of most in the bottom side. Well, let's revert to the original one, which was 0 degrees, and let's change for the moment for the other one, the checker. The checker is, of course, placement is repeat X, seats, repeats Y, seats, and the change is like this. Ah, Well, in this example, only this or this. This material looks well too uninterested. If I show the preview tiling, well, the material, of course, have tiling because R is one of the features from QuizSolmeter. All right. In this case, with this example, I want to use the circle one. This circle one looks good for today. I can use this one with the original one, six to six. Well, the original one was 4 to 4. And the purpose of today is to explore for the Unreal Engine 4.22 and show this material in Unreal Engine, and that's all that I will do for today. All right, for the moment I finish. Okay, this one, of course, all of the properties that I show today pues is enough, at least in this streaming. All right, but next is to say this material I finished looks good. I already showed the previous tiling, it is working well. Hide the previous tiling, and after that the next step is to export to bits or QuizSolmeter bits. How can I do that? Go to the file menu and show export to library, and there is immediately a preview. I can choose roughness also, and the name is already updated, Jungle Ring Floor 3. Select category. Today, mastering mixer. Area 2 for 2 meters. It's okay. Let's port. All right, let's go to bridge. Is this one? This is QuizSolmeter. All right. There is a command. It is reload. It is called reload. It's already my. It's updating or something like that. This is the last one sample that I had just exported from QuizSolmeter. This is the sample. I can click and there is a preview which have the same name, Jungle Ring Floor 3, and test your resolution 2K for Unreal Engine is enough. Test your formal TGA. I finish okay TGA. And export to Unreal Engine version 2.22. Installation folder, the default one, C program files, Epic Games, UEFI 4.22 engine plugins. Of course, it is necessary to install the Megascan plugin. Have to install using this path. However, to export this material to the Unreal is necessary to. From here, you can show the texture which is part of this material. Open in folder. Here are these textures, random textures from this example jungle green floor. All of these ones, it is reading all of these ones on textures. All right, it is reading. In general, there is a preview, no? I'm in a closion. Diffuse, displacement, gloss, normal, roughness, specular, and a preview of this material. Tombos and some JSON file. Well, after the next step is to export to Unreal. First go to the Unreal Engine. This one, and just want to see where am I. Of course, when the Megascan plugin were installed, after that, in the Unreal Engine, the Megascan plugin appears here. Of course, there are some options. Visit Megascan, documentation about surface, with other options, etc. Next step is only sport. All right. I back to bridge and let's sport. From this command, sport. And it is exporting to Unreal Engine. Sport is successful. Let's switch to Unreal Engine. And it was faster because already the first you right here. The texture are all of these ones and the material. All right, the material is this one, which is a master from Quizol. If there are some missing texture, you need to import manually because the normal and the roughness are already here in this material, which is called 2 Jungle Ring Floor 3, etc. Instanciado. Instance from the Faren with gold standard master material. And there are other options. However, for the moment, there is only a very initial material, and is the diffuse one. Let's go to the Windows. This one, and in this case, there are the previous all of these textures already show. I mean, occlusion, diffuse, displacement, gloss, normal. This one is the is jungle rain floors 2K diffuse. There are two ones. All right, let's use this one. Unless it's import to the Unreal and let's choose this texture in this albedo. And of course, the material change because of, let's see, for example, if one change the table items, of course, we can see the normal map details. Of course, for example, this one is, or this one, metallic, let's hide. The next step is to say everything with the shortcut. Let's change this. Already prepare this very easy scene. It is only an empty scene with light mass important volume, some point lines, and already had some material, some previous material. I can update to the to this one, which is called to jungle rain floor 3. I can choose an update in as element 0. The materials properties, let's assign, and as you can see, the scale is very, is bigger. What can I do? Well, I can change the tiling basically. Let's back this new material, go to the light mode, and go to the tiling and apply, for example, a scale or date for the tiling. There are other properties, for example, enable subdivision, enable desolation, and there are some confluent shaders. That's one is an out course, the material already have the texture or map, and the normal and the roughness, and the compiling shaders, the shaders. All right, it looks good in general. Well, can change this one, displacement multiplier, displacement offset, can experiment with some values, for example, here 10, or the default 20, and it is taking place here. The displayment offset 5 maybe, and the result is like this. All right, maybe use the materials like this, or the original, in the original way. All right, let's see in the gameplay. Simply apply the play command, and this is the final material. Can clip the F4 and try to see the normal map details because of the detail lighting. Click F3 and see the details of this new material. And this could be the final material. Of course, Megascan plugin has many other option to experiment, of course. However, for the moment, it's enough with this material. All right. It looks very well here in this preview. Try to see the changes. Maybe the default value are enough for this example. Or can show these ones with their original values, for example 10, displayment multiplier 10, and displayment offset maybe 5. Just as an example. Let's save all, and I think it could be the original material. Let's say all. Let's play. The level name was called QMBMFs. This is the 4.22 version of the Unreal Engine. That's it. Let's change in the level. Looks very good. All right, of course this is an instant material, and of course can change other settings, for example the color overlay, normal intensity, for example 1 0 is very flat, normal intensity 1 1 is better. Overlay intensity, roughness intensity, now is 1, maybe 0. Of course, the material could be more flat. In this case, is losing well. Or maybe it could have for example, roughness intensity equal 0.5. Maybe change the color, it is possible, to the red ones, or to the blue ones, or the green ones, or yellow, or the change to this option, color wheel, color spectrum, try to use maybe more familiar colors, more easy, or an easy way, for maybe like this, or more saturated, etc. I think the default one is the best value. Well, I think, let's see. Yes, it's the default value is half green. A 50% of the greens. All right, let's go to the gameplay. It looks better. We love those properties. Looks better the normal map. Let's change to the F3. All right, it looks better. F3, it looks well. It looks like an dragon skin or dino skin or something like that. It is too green. All right. Well, I finish. Time to finish this streaming. All right. As always, thanks for watching. That's it. Let's say all. That's it.